Welcome, everybody, to the loudest podcast on the internet. This week, we are celebrating a big milestone, Sriracha. You know what milestone we're celebrating?
Is it 364,492 downloads?
No. No, 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 no. We wish we were there. We are celebrating our 254,300th download.
Woo! Take your top off.
We crossed the 250 mark, a quarter of a million downloads, and then a couple more downloads. Thank you guys so much for sharing the show and sharing our best of clips with your friends and turning your friends on to the loudest podcast. It's really nice of you.
Really nice of you. We appreciate almost all of you that leave voicemails.
So we thought, you know, to celebrate that we have over a quarter of a million downloads, we'd bring back some of our favorite bits from the past. And one of the bits that I really like is playing Funko or Faco.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Because then I just get to spend hours, like, reading about Funko Pops as, like, research.
Oh, yeah. Wait, don't tell me. Don't tell me that you've been staring at them for so long that you think they're cool now.
The BoJack Horseman Funkos? I was like, oh, I kind of want these.
No, fuck off. It's serious. You can't do that. That's like they did studies on this. OK, like the more you see something or a product, the more your brain will want to buy it. That's why those fucking advertisements stalk you around the Internet. Those AdSense that you ever been looking at something and then it just appears on every fucking website you go on.
Yeah, you've had that happen to you. I haven't, because I'm VPN pill now. All these fucking cookies think I'm in the United Kingdom now. So I keep getting ads for like, oh, Jeremy's Chip Shop. Oh, come on in, governor. And it's like, I will never go there. But I do kind of want to go there, actually.
I mean, I kind of want to go to Jeremy's Chip Shop. But anyway, let's talk about some Funko Pops.
All right. Now we're going to play Funko or Faco. Sriracha, it is your job to determine whether the Funko Pop I tell you about is a real Funko Pop or one that I made up.
Okay.
Let's start with the category musicians who have tragically died.
Oh, yay.
Jim Morrison Funko Pop. Funko or Faco?
Funko.
Wrong! It's a Faco! There is no Jim Morrison Funko Pop. Sorry, fans of the Lizard King. Can't have a cute little Lizard King on your desk. Lisa Left Eye Lopez. Oh. Funko or Faco?
I personally believe that a lot of these sound like they could. Is it bad that my first thought is all of these are going to be real because I could totally see Funko whoring themselves out from dead people. I'm going to go real.
Yeah, that's a Funko. You can absolutely buy Lisa Left Eye Lopez. I mean, the reason why a lot of these are going to be real is that, well, they're not around to say no anymore. Do you think Lisa Left Eye Lopez's kids or nieces or whoever controls the Lopez Foundation? Like, yeah, sure, we'll take some of our dead aunt's money. Tupac Shakur.
Absolutely real.
Yes, that is a Funko. Yes.
I personally knew that one because I saw something on Reddit at one point. It was like, I'm going to put my Biggie and my Tupac Funko Pops together. I was like, I hate the internet. We need to go back.
Mac Miller. Funko Pop.
Oh, I don't know, because he died of a heroin overdose, I think. I think that's a little too far, even for the Funko. I'm going to say no to Mac Miller Funko Pop.
Faco. There is no Mac Miller Funko Pop yet. Tweet at Funko Pop on Twitter. Let's get Mac Miller.
It comes with a hypodermic needle.
I mean, there are a lot of musicians who overdosed, and there's Funko Pops of them. Like, didn't Jimi Hendrix overdose?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Well, you can buy Jimi Hendrix Funko Pop. But finally, though, and again, speaking of someone who died of substance abuse, Amy Winehouse, Funko or Faco?
Oh, that's got to be real.
That's right. There is an Amy Winehouse Funko Pop. All right. Now let's go to our next category, musicians who have tragically not died. Adam Levine from Maroon 5.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Funko or Faco?
Ah, this is tough. This is a good one. I don't think that's going to be real because I don't think anybody gives a shit enough about Adam Levine in 2021. So I'm going to say Faco.
You don't think people give enough of a shit about the host of The Voice?
He hosts The Voice?
Yeah, he's one of the guys in that chair.
Oh, no.
Well, you were right. It's Faco. There is no Adam Levine Funko Pop. You're doing great. Mark Hoppus from Blink 182.
Oh, wait. Do I win a prize if I get a certain percentage of these right?
You know what? Yeah, yeah, sure. If you get more than half of them right, I'll Venmo you $10.
Woo, okay.
All right, Mark Hoppus from Blink 182. Funko or Faco?
Well, okay. Well, I don't know who that is, but I know Blink 182 is the band that put their album Non-Consensually on everybody else. Or was that Coldplay? I don't remember.
That was U2, actually.
Oh, shit. Okay. Nico would be so upset with me. Speaking of which, we're doing DSJ tonight. We watched a Promising Young Woman. Nico is very mad at it, and I'm afraid to tell her this, but I kind of liked it.
A lot of people like that movie. I think Nico hates that movie because a lot of people like that movie. She's a punk rock contrarian.
Yeah, that's true. She's the type of woman that listens to music that I think is objectively bad.
Well, you just don't like music.
I don't like music. Isn't that embarrassing? Anyways, I'm going to say yes to Blink 182 guy.
Correct. There is Mark Hoppus Blink 182 Funko, but is there a Travis Barker from Blink 182 Funko?
Is that the drummer?
I don't know.
I'm going to say no.
There is a Travis Barker Funko.
No, I was doing so well.
So there's a Mark Hoppus Funko. There's a Travis Barker Funko. Now let's see if some of the tertiary members of Blink 182 are in there. Is there a Tom DeLonge Funko Pop?
Who is Tom? Is he like a backup singer?
Would it matter if you knew he played rhythm guitar? You don't know who this band is.
Yeah. There is
no Tom DeLonge. That's a fake-o.
No.
There's also no Matt Skiba, and there's no Scott Rayner. All right, let's move on to play sets. They wanted to make little locations that you could put your Funko Pop in. So let me pitch you this one first. BoJack Horseman's Pool, which does not come with BoJack Horseman. Is that a Funko or a Faco?
Oh, fuck. This is hard. This is going to be the hardest category for me because I have literally never seen one of these, and I don't know if you're just making this shit up.
No, you got to be a real addict to buy a little Funko Pop, like a Funko Pop break room for your Funko Pop The Office figures.
Yeah, oh, fuck. I'm going to say no to BoJack's pool.
You're absolutely right.
Fuck,
that was a Faco, but for bonus points, can you name all 5 BoJack Funkos?
Yes, I think I can.
All right.
I'm going to go Princess Caroline.
Yes.
BoJack.
Yes.
Diane.
Yes.
Mr. Peanut Butter.
Yes.
Oh, so I got 4 of them already?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, fuck. The last one, Todd.
Yes! Oh, my God, you got them all! I'm telling you, when you see these Funko Pops, you're going to freak out.
I don't want any Funko Pops in this fucking household.
All right. Hagrid's house, which does not come with a Hagrid Funko Pop. It's just his house. Funko or Faco?
I'm going to go Funko on that one.
That is absolutely right. You can buy Hagrid's house, and it comes with Hagrid's dog, Fang, a character everyone loves.
I'm getting so good at this.
I'm
really good at Funko or Faco.
You're very good at this. And then the final one in this category, the Ghostbusters Firehouse, which does not come with Peter Venkman. Funko or Faco?
Oh, now this sounds like this is a toughie. This sounds like an ideal candidate for a Funko or Faco. I knew that the pool thing wouldn't be real because how are you going to make a pool? But this is tough. I'm going to go Faco.
You're absolutely right. Because
damn,
of course
yes!
It comes with Peter Venkman. They're not monsters. You can't have the firehouse without Peter Venkman in there.
Did I get 100% in that category?
Yeah, you aced that category. S tier so far.
Fuck yeah.
Moving us on to food and candy mascots.
Oh, Jesus.
Captain Cupcake, the Hostess Cupcake mascot, Funko or Faco?
I'm going to say Faco, and I don't think that exists.
Funko, you're wrong. There is a Captain Cupcake.
What does it look like?
It is a traditional Hostess cupcake, you know, the ones with like the squiggly icing going down the center. And it has a little like captain's hat. It's like a little Navy captain. He's like smoking a little pipe. He's got gloves on. These are from like the 70s and 60s when your mascots could smoke.
Damn.
King Ding Dong, the Hostess Ding Dong mascot, Funko or Faco?
Is this all going to be snack cakes?
Yeah, this is the food and candy category.
I know, but the category of food and candy, I think, encompasses more than Hostess products.
Okay, you know what? I will rename this category to snack cakes because all 4 of these are packaged snack cakes you can buy at the store.
I wonder what's at the forefront of your mind these days.
I miss snacks!
Anyways, it's a Twinkie. What were you talking about?
King Ding Dong, the Hostess Ding Dong mascot. Funko? No, that's a Funko too!
Fuck.
You've never heard of King Ding Dong? The King of the Ding Dongs?
I've never heard of the King there of the Ding Dogs.
He is adorable. It's a ding dong. He has a little crown. He has a scepter. It's adorable. Helmet, the Yodeling Yodels Yodler mascot. Funko or Fako?
Helmet?
Helmut.
Helmut.
He's a little Yodeling Yodler. So he's going like yodeling hee hoo, but he's a yodel.
Is he German or Russian?
He's Bavarian. He's got like the lederhosen, and he's climbing a mountain.
Fako.
You're damn right. There is no helmet, the Yodeling Yodler. And then finally, Chuckles, the Funny Bones stand-up skeleton. Funko or Fako?
Funny Bones?
You've never heard of Funny Bones? They're
no.
a Drake's cake. They're delicious. It's like a little chocolate cake, and it's got peanut butter in the middle. Funny Bones.
Funko.
Wrong!
Fuck.
Chuckles, the Funny Bones stand-up skeleton is something I invented. And actually, wait. Hold on 1 second.
Thank you for calling McKee Foods Corporation. Cakes and home of Webster the Duck. This call may be recorded for quality and training purposes.
What do you bet they hang up on you immediately after you start talking?
Good afternoon, Consumer Affairs. How can I help you?
My name is Stereos Kogaros from the Loudest Podcast. This call is being recorded. I wanted to pitch you guys an idea for a mascot for Funny Bones. What do you?
As much as we do appreciate you calling, you know, and wanting to share your ideas, much appreciated. Unfortunately, we're just not able to take suggestions and ideas, simply because we do have an ideas department, and they're always working on new products and new ideas. And just to prevent any sort of conflict that could arise, we're just not able to take those. But we do appreciate you taking the time to call and share that with us.
His name is Chuckles the Funny Bone stand-up skeleton. You know the funny bones you sell? What if there was a skeleton and he was doing
stand-up? You're going to get her in trouble.
She hung up.
And now you were blocked by the Hostess Corporation.
That's the Drake's Corporation. They're two different corporations.
Yeah, well, people talk, Stereos. People talk in this industry. It's a hard game out here. You get blacklisted from one idea department. You get blacklisted from them all.
It's such a good idea. Imagine he's like a little Fozzie Bear telling jokes like, hey, I'm more delicious than a dog. Okay, I haven't written any jokes yet, but these jokes would be great.
I really like how she felt the need to explain the fact that their legal department can't accept them to two obviously crazy people.
Is it my fault that I sound like a child? It is absolutely not. Now, this next category is real people. These are Funko Pops named after real people. Is there a Funko Icons Pop Series Keanu Reeves Funko Pop?
Absolutely.
Wrong! That's a Fako!
Really?
Yes, there is no Keanu Reeves going, "I think you're beautiful too," on the stage of Comic-Con to a lady. There's no Keanu Reeves doing like the fun Keanu walk or eating ice cream. Your favorite meme is not a Funko Pop yet.
Damn, they are missing out on billions of Reddit dollars.
I know, but let's see if they're missing out on this next Funko. Michelle Obama Pop Series Funko Icons Funko Pop.
Real.
Wrong! There is no Michelle Obama!
No, I'm blowing it!
There's a Hillary, there's a Trump, and there's a Bernie, but there's no Barack or Michelle.
Wham, I wonder why.
My guess is that they just kind of weren't as big a deal back then.
Okay, I guess.
All right. Funko Icons Pop Series Bill Nye Funko Pop. Funko or Fako?
That has got to be real.
That is real. You can buy Bill Nye. Not Bill Nye the Science Guy. That's a licensed character. Just regular Bill Nye.
Just regular Bill Nye.
And then finally, and this is going to be the hardest one.
Damn.
Is there a Funko Icons Pop Series Ruth Bader Ginsburg Funko Pop?
Oh, God. Okay. Oh, Asterius, my mental health wants me to believe that there's not, but I think that it's a Funko, like a real thing.
Is that your Funko answer?
That's my final Funko.
Okay. Take a look at that television for the answer.
Oh, my. my God!
Yes, there is! Look at her! She's so empowered! Oh, she's a girl boss! The ultimate girl boss! Ruth Bader Ginsburg, have her on your desk! Oh, there you go, girl boss! RPG, notorious RPG, Funko Pop! Yes, she's real! She's real!
Get AOC and put them right next to each other. I hate this. I want to die. Did I win $10? I need $10 to make me feel better about this.
Now, unfortunately, out of the 20 questions I asked you, you only got 12 of them right, so you do get $10.
And I get a bonus point because I got all the BoJack Horsemans.
All right, I got 17 points. All right, now look, you're getting $10, okay? I don't know how much more $10 you can get.
Woo! $10.
All right, we will be right back after this with more of our The Loudest Podcast 254,300th Download Spectacular.
Woo!
I'm so upset. I'm so upset. I'm so upset. I'm so upset. I feel terrible. Oh my God. I haven't had sugar in weeks. My body is crying out for garbage all the time. It's going, where'd the garbage go? You've been giving us garbage for 38 years. Where's the garbage? My nutritionist is a war criminal. Mayor McCheese, if you can hear this, I formally seek asylum from McDonaldland. I'm gonna die. Welcome to The Loudest Podcast. I'm Mysterios Coconuts. With us, as always, is Sriracha.
I'm Sriracha. I feel pretty good. I feel no complaints over
here. Oh, really? Oh, you feel good?
Yeah, I feel great.
Okay.
But then again, you need to consider that I have gotten my 100% my daily value of McDonald's today.
Oh, all right. So you might remember a couple of weeks ago, I said I was considering going to a nutritionist. Sriracha told me not to. And she was right, by the way. Tell me not to go to a nutritionist. I am officially nutrition pilled.
Holy shit.
I'm organic pilled. I'm not, you know, free range isn't enough for my chickens. They also have to be pasture raised.
They have to have the opportunity to go to college.
Yeah, they get little degrees and they take their little claw foot and move the tassel from one side to the other before we chop off their heads and I eat them. Oh my God. I have, okay, Sriracha, guess how much money I have spent on supplements?
I'm going to guess $200.
$200?
Yeah.
Are you out of your mind?
Clearly.
You can't get supplements for $200? Higher.
$500.
$500. What am I made of money here? No, $451.
Damn, I was close.
You were close on supplements. Let me read a list to you of everything I'm eating now. And for people who subscribe to the video version, you'll also get to see these beautiful labels which have bankrupted me. First off, every day I have to take 800 milligrams of magnesium. But not any magnesium will do for my nutritionist. Who, by the way, her name is like Saffron, Sunflower, like Moon, Crystal Moon. But she's got some stupid name. And she's like, no, no, no. You have to buy Truvani magnesium from the Dead Sea.
Holy shit. I was going to say, we have like a gallon of magnesium powder in the kitchen, but I guess that simply won't do for my nutrition-pilled co-host.
Absolutely no. Your magnesium is trash. It's garbage.
Clearly.
You need magnesium from the Dead Sea. You need magnesium that Moses' feet once touched as he parted the Red Sea to bring the Jews to safety. You gotta take two of these. Also, I have to take three of these. You know how much fucking turmeric curcumin I'm eating a day?
Let me tell you, that stuff tastes like shit. I've been taking it every day, too. I'm sick of it already. Okay, let me ask you a question. When you take your turmeric, do you put...
No, it's not turmeric. It's turmeric curcumin with organic black pepper from Truvani. Get it right. I'm not just dumping a shaker full of turmeric into my mouth, which I would love to do because it would be much cheaper.
Okay, well, when you put the chalk in your mouth, do you take the pill and put it in first and then drink the water? Or do you drink the water and then like drop it in like a fish?
I put the pills in my mouth first.
Big mistake, because they start melting immediately, right? Yeah. And then you taste black pepper and curcumin, and oh, it's disgusting.
Yeah, my fucking mouth tastes like a Turkish bazaar. Like, I can't get that water down my gullet fast enough. But it's like, Oh, you know what the turmeric does? Why, it fights the free radicals in my blood. What are free radicals? I don't know, but they're free, and someone has to lock up these radicals.
Those radicals need to pay for what they've done. They know what they've done.
I'm taking vitamin D, which is fine, because I guess my nutritionist took one look at me, and she's like, you're not going outside. I can tell you're going to... We're going to give up on you getting your vitamin D from the sun. Now you're going to get it from Hum Nutritionals. Beauty starts from within.
Who is going outside these days, though? Come on.
Yeah, I know. Okay, that's fair. I'm also taking... Oh, my God. And then here's the big one.
Oh, I need one of those. I need one of those.
Oh, you do? Oh, okay. Well, then pay up, Buttercup, because this is a $120 bottle of multivitamin.
Oh, my God.
It's not just any multivitamin. Metagenics Phytomulti with iron. That's right, because my vitamins have to be biodynamic now.
I don't get why.
I don't know. I don't know, but I saw this nutritionist. She was very skinny, and I was like, all right, well, whatever it takes to get what you have, I'll do it. I'll buy it. I'll eat it. I'll throw it up. Just, I want to be skinny.
We're getting you prescription-grade cocaine next. I've heard that developing a coke addiction is a really easy way to lose weight.
Yeah, you think she's joking, right, listeners? Even this is like her being satirical. But yesterday, I saw her seriously considering starting to use cocaine.
Oh, I'm seriously considering it right this second.
Why are you thinking of taking the white pill?
Because it seems like an easier time than stopping eating pasta and McDonald's. Next question, please.
I know you think models become skinny by doing cocaine.
And they do.
No.
Yes.
They become skinny because I've worked with models in the pain because I've worked in television for 10 years. This is what they do, and I'm not kidding, and it's awful. They buy these special machines that make ice chips. Like, you know how pregnant women can only suck on ice chips? They can't have water? Same with models. Then they dip the ice chip in orange juice to give it a little bit of flavoring. That's what they eat all day. The reason they take cocaine isn't to become skinny. It's because they're so depressed and upset that they can't eat, that they need the cocaine to make them feel happy and up.
Ice chip, you say? What if we sprinkle a little cocaine in the ice chips?
All right. Moving back to my thing. Listeners, help. Can you please tweet at Sriracha and tell her not to start a cocaine addiction? She's getting very excited about it lately.
I don't even want to start doing cocaine. I want to develop a cocaine addiction.
God damn it. She's trying to do medicinal cocaine. And to be fair, that is how we used to sell it. All right. So this Metagenics Phytomultivitamin. By the way, no joke, you can only get this vitamin from a doctor.
Really? No. Why?
You can't. Because it's biodynamic. And
what does that mean?
And because it's an adaptogen. It's full of antioxidants. There's no food fraud in this. No label stuffing. No greenwashing. Foganic. Get out of here. That's how good these vitamins are. Guess how much thiamine is in this multivitamin.
Is it a percentage or a number of grams?
No one knows the gram thing. Go with percentage. What's my daily percentage of thiamine?
I know you need lots of thyroid to lose weight. So I'm going to say 200% thyroid.
200% thiamine? Try 2,083% of the thiamine you need.
Holy fucking shit.
In each of these giant... Oh, by the way, these giant horse pills also glow an eerie blue.
I bet you I could swallow it without water.
All right, here you go.
All right, let's see. This is gigantic. This is almost the two-thirds of the size of my pinky.
Yeah, and it's the same color of like a Street Sharks brand gummy from the 90s.
Oh, God, that hurt.
You dry swallowed it?
I did.
But it's a biodynamic adaptogen. Oh, God.
Well, now my throat's going to need to adapt to this pretty quickly.
Guess how much panthoic acid I'm getting a day from this.
Pan-African acid. I'm going to say 500%.
1,500% of the pantoic acid I need to become skinny as fuck.
Holy shit.
And then finally, and this one's my favorite, guess how much vitamin B12, which is present as methocyanobalamin, is here.
Methocyanobalamin, you say. I'm going to say 5,000%.
That's for cucks, Sriracha. Clearly. I'm paying $120 for these vitamins. So I'm getting 8,333% of the myosioapathin I need a day from these. And by the way, if you're wondering if I'm happier now, no, I'm not. I'm absolutely not. My nutritionist was like, you know, maybe your anxiety and depression will be made better by this magnesium, by this turmeric or curamate, by this riothiboapatite. No, I'm way more depressed now because I lost $450 on these stupid vitamins.
Hey, let me ask you a question. Is your piss like bright yellow now?
Is my piss turmeric tan? Yes, it is. Yes. My piss looks like khakis now, but I thought that was a good thing.
You said my piss also looks like khakis now, and I'm afraid for my life.
I'm pissing the color of Old Navy in the 90s. It's pretty good. So the whole thing with my nutritionist is she's like, everything you eat has to be nutritionally dense.
Oh, Jesus. I can already tell this is going to be annoying.
Yeah, yes, exactly. So it's like, I'm not allowed to eat white bread because that's bleached. White rice. The white is out. Brown is in. I have to eat 2 bean fibers a day. So if you're wondering what mung bean pasta tastes like, not very good.
The answer is shit.
Yeah, and I'm buying black beans, but they have to be organic, unsalted black beans. They just taste like water. Just tell me to have a bowl of water if you want me to drink water.
I mean, if you did want to lose weight, just drinking a bowl of water every time. I think that's called soup, bowl of water.
Well, I have in 2 weeks, I have lost over 10 pounds.
Holy shit, congratulations.
Yeah, I've lost 13 pounds, and this is why. Because everything she has me eating is packed with so much fiber that I'm just shitting nonstop. I call it butt-lemia. It's just grain fibers, whole grain fibers, bean fibers, fruit fibers. It's just, and then she has me keeping track of everything I eat on this little like D&D style character sheet where it's got like I have to like open up Microsoft Excel every time I eat something to track like how many bean fibers have I had today. One day I had 3 bean fibers instead of 2 bean fibers. Saffron Cinnamon Crystal was not happy with me at all.
I imagine your digestive tract was not happy with you either.
Yeah, because it's like everyone's always like, oh, the gut flora, gut flora. Everyone's like, well, why are you addicted to bad food? Because like your gut becomes like dependent on processed foods and shit. I have like 40 years of McDonald's in my
caked
guts.
Caked up in your guts?
Yeah, there's like literally just a little drive-thru down there. Like Grimace is like hanging out in my guts. Like my colon is full of Fry Guys.
Oh my God, they live down there.
They live down there. They work down there. They're having a great time. Now they're having a terrible time down there. I am going through the same withdrawal from sugar that like a heroin addict goes through. We've all read the article that's based on a study that none of us read that's like, oh, sugar's more addictive than heroin and cocaine combined. I always thought that was crap. No, it's absolutely true. I can't think straight. I can't walk straight. Oh, and by the way, the only reason I woke up in the morning was to drink that like fun coffee that tastes like cereal or mint chocolate chips or peanut butter. Guess what? A surprising amount of that taste came from the sugar I would just dump in my coffee every morning. So now I'm waking up and my coffee just tastes like coffee that someone maybe showed a Fruity Pebble to once.
Yeah, you know what this sounds like? This sounds like the thing that keto people get, the keto fog. Have you ever heard of that?
What? No.
Oh, okay. So when you first start on keto, sometimes you will get this thing called the keto fog, and I get it real hard, which I think I get it more severely than most people, because most people I read on the internet, they're like, oh, I'm just a little bit out of it for the first 2 days that I stop eating carbs. But I'm like, I can't think in a straight line. On the first 2 days that I'm on keto, like I will completely just be sitting there and like staring off into space. And then it's 3 hours later I'm like, oh shit, where did my day get away from me? Oh no, I was just staring at nothing. My head hurts. It feels like I got hit by a fucking bat. Are you experiencing kind of some of the same things?
Yeah, I was getting headaches a lot. I was getting headaches. They have gone away, thank God, but like the fog hasn't. And I feel bad for you because like sometimes I'll be talking to you and we'll be trying to figure out what TV show to put on or something. And I'll just turn to you and I'll be like, I can't.
Please, no, I can't handle these obese women screaming at each other on television anymore.
Well, no, it's not that. I love the obese women screaming at each other on television. But like, but I have trouble picking between 90 Day Fiancé, colon, happily ever after, 90 Day Fiancé, colon, before the 90 days, colon, tells all, colon, strikes back, colon, pillow talk. There's so many 90 Day Fiancés, and if I could eat a Snickers bar, I could know which one I wanted to watch.
Don't forget 90 Day Journeys, which is the clip show of every single couple that's ever been on 90 Days, available now on Discovery Plus. Man, I fucking hate how much I'm using Discovery Plus. It makes me real mad.
I told you you would love Discovery Plus.
I am addicted to Discovery Plus.
My mom is on our Discovery Plus account too, and so it's like, ooh, my mom's really into Ghost Brothers, which is, by the way, in case you're wondering, is Ghost Brothers a show about two African-American brothers who look for ghosts? The answer is yes. It's the most on-the-nose named show I've ever heard in my life.
I just assumed that they killed the Property Brothers finally. Now they're making them haunt the houses before they sell them.
So my nutritionist, she's like, oh, but you know, 3 times a week, you can be a little bit bad. And so she's like, you can have a discretionary. She calls them discretionaries. And she made me a whole list of discretionaries. And I shit you not, one of the discretionaries was like, oh, if you want to be bad, you can have an organic watermelon popsicle as like a sweet treat. And I'm like, why don't you eat my asshole as a sweet treat? Huh? I got a sweet treat for you. Die! What did you die? Oh my God, I'm so upset.
Oh my God, go fuck yourself. That's like insult to injury. Like, why would you even say, like, oh, if you want to be a wee bit naughty, you can go from organic quinoa to regular quinoa. It's like, fuck you, you know. That's not what that word means, you stupid bitch. All right,
Saffron Crystal, I'm so sorry. If you're listening to this, I would never go to conventional quinoa. I swear to God, I will only eat organic quinoa. I swear to God. Please, please don't take away my discretionaries. Please, they're all I have. Oh, okay. So on Monday, my discretionaries reset. Just like in D&D, like your daily powers reset after a day or after a long rest, you get your encounter powers back. And my discretionaries reset. And I was like, oh, thank God. I can go to the health food store and I can buy a dark chocolate bar.
Oh my God, Asteria, who am I talking to? This can't possibly be Asteria.
I know. The worst kind of chocolate. So this week I got 95% organic, stone ground dark chocolate. And I swear to God, it tasted like somebody just compressed a bunch of cat shit into a shingle. And was like, eat this as a sweet treat. And I'm like, I've been waiting all week for my discretionary to refill. I'm in the health food store. I couldn't wait to get out of the health food store before I started eating it. Thank God they don't believe COVID-19 exists, because they're all taking Manuka honey, which they're like, COVID-19 has no power here. We're all eating Manuka honey, which costs $50 a jar. And I was like, so what is this, what does Manuka honey do for you? And they're like, oh, it fights cancer. And I'm like, you're eating honey to fight cancer? You really think that honey's going to fight cancer?
To be fair, when you're in the cancer ward, how many bees do you see in there?
Oh, touche. And so I'm eating this, and it tastes terrible, and I'm just chewing on it, and it's turning into little tiny cat turds in my mouth. And I'm crying, and I'm crying, and I'm crying. I'm just like, I'm so upset. I'm so upset. I just want to eat regular chocolate like a regular boy. But this is what happens, listeners, when you spend your whole life treating your body like a garbage dump, you will eventually have to pay the bill. And I swear to God, listeners, this is going to happen to you one day, too. One day you're going to wake up. You're only going to be allowed to eat Dave 21 grain whole grain bread or Messenmacher bread. Sriracha, would you care to describe Messenmacher bread?
Messenmacher bread is what would happen if a baker was like, I need to fix this hole in my house, but I only have ingredients for bread. And then he invented a form of bread that you could use to fucking chuck at someone and kill them. That bread is not edible. That bread is not food. It tastes like eating grass.
It's awful. It is this Messenmacher bread. You could kill a man with this bread.
I totally believe you. And listeners, let me tell you, even if you don't treat your body like a complete garbage, mine's like a recycling plant. Because I eat things out of the garbage.
Oh, stop doing that! Stop that!
Even if your body's more of a recycling plant than a garbage dump. Like, I was laying in bed the other night thinking to myself, oh my God, I need to get to sleep because the sooner I sleep, the more I can wake up and eat some organic lentil pasta. It's fucking pathetic. So I will develop just an organic cocaine addiction.
God damn it, sir! All right. We'll be right back right after this with more of The Loudest Podcast. There's still a couple of days left, if you're listening to this, to get this month's Sticker Club sticker. It is a Friday Night Funkin' sticker. I tried playing that game. It hurt my hand.
But you goddamn Zoomers, you love that game, so go get the sticker.
It is me as boyfriend. It is Sriracha as girlfriend. The dad that we're fighting is Nathan Masary. And a lot of people are asking, who did the art for this amazing sticker? Because they're sharing the sticker on Twitter. Everybody loves this sticker. It's doing very, very well. It was drawn by a new artist to our little collective here, Dylan from the Broskies. A lot of people know he's a funny comedian. They know he's a very good editor. They didn't know he's also an incredibly good artist.
Well, now you know. Follow him on Instagram.
But you only got a couple of days left to get that Friday Night Funkin' sticker. You go to patreon.com/stereos. For just $15, you join our Sticker of the Month Club. And every month, you get an amazing sticker from artists like Mimi Yori and Berries and Cream and Kibi. And now Dylan's in the mix. But you gotta pledge by the last day of the month to get this month's sticker.
How many days? It's May 25th, the day we're recording this, so you have a very limited amount of time. You have to go now. Do it.
Go right
go,
now!
Go,
throw your phone in the garbage and go!
Steal mom's credit card.
Do it! Welcome back to The Loudest Podcast. One of our favorite things to talk about on this show is 90 Day Fiancé.
Oh, God, yes. There's so many. I could talk about 90. I could probably do a whole podcast just about 90 Day Fiancé Minute.
I think about doing that all the time, just you and me. Because the nice thing about 90 Day Fiancé is there is a new one each week. If it's not 90 Day Fiancé flagship, like right now it's 90 Day Fiancé : happily ever after ?
Yeah, which is just where they get married and then they just live. And it's so entertaining because they managed to find the world's best fuck ups for this show.
It's really good. We're always watching the show and we're always like screaming, like, why are you doing that? Why are you so stupid? Why are you doing what you're doing? And then we're like, oh, wait, if they weren't idiots, they wouldn't be on television in the first place.
Exactly.
So there's another show in the 90 Day universe called 90 Day Fiancé : The Single Life.
Oh, it's so good. And let me tell you, they're really like pushing the fuck out of the fact that they can swear on this one.
Oh, yeah. They're dropping F-bombs. They're talking about like graphic sexual acts.
Right. Like they're talking about specific sexual acts they're performing on one another.
Yeah, it's awesome. And the idea of The Single Life is, well, after all their disastrous 90-day marriages broke up, let's like continue to follow the adventures of the worst people in the series. The worst. Like the biggest villains in 90-day history. And so two of the main stars of 90-day Fiancé The Single Life are Colt and Big Ed. Sriracha, maybe tell us, why do people hate Colt so much?
Okay, well, Colt. Okay, so Colt is a big fat moron. Colt has one mission in life, like his mission, his overarching mission. That mission is to get Brazilian pussy. So the first series that Colt appeared on, Colt starts dating this woman named Larissa. And there's no way that I can confirm this, but my speculation with a lot of these couples is that a lot of these dudes, here's every season of 90 Day Fiancé, you ready? Hi, I'm an obese American sex tourist. I am an American and I have lots of money and I will give you lots of money if you date me. And then the girl says, hello, obese American sex tourist. I am a 20-year-old who's younger than your daughter. I will have sex with you in exchange for money. And they get to the United States and the girl says, I would like some money now. And then they're like, why don't you love me for me? All you care about is money. Don't you love me for me, or are you just here for the green card? That's every fucking season of 90 Day Fiancé. And in my speculation, I think that's what's going on here, because Larissa comes to the United States and says, I would like new titties. I would like a Chanel bag. Where the fuck are my flowers? Why does your car have no air conditioning? And an interesting thing about Colt and Ed is that both of them have an attack dog. Colt's attack dog is his mother, Debbie, who he lives with and who is a fucking bitch and, like, it just has her, is all up in their business. We don't know exactly what happened with Colt and Larissa. Larissa gets the call. An event occurs and Larissa gets the cops called on her 3 times. They break up. Colt had, like, cuts off data to her cell phone or something and tries to get her deported. He fails. She gets married to another American dude. Colt then goes back to Brazil seeking additional Brazilian pussy with his attack dog Debbie in tow, and meets this girl named Jess. And Jess, he meets Jess while she's on like a working visa, but she's like, I have to fuck off back to Brazil now. Do you want to come to Brazil and meet my family? He's like, yeah, if I can bring my mom. And she's like, yeah, sure, whatever. And Debbie at this point is like, no, you will not get another Brazilian pussy. I am going to be there and I'm going to fucking cock block at every step of this relationship. So inevitably they end up breaking up. Because Debbie also calls like Colt's fuck buddy to their house and has them feed the cats. And Colt has been lying. The girl's name is Vanessa. And Colt has been lying to his Brazilian girlfriend, Jess. The lore on this show is so deep. Colt has been lying to his Brazilian girlfriend, Jess, saying that I don't talk to Vanessa. I know we used to date, but I don't talk to Vanessa anymore. This, that, and the other thing. And then Debbie's like, Vanessa's at the house. Here, look at these pictures Vanessa's sending me. So Jess breaks into Colt's cell phone and texts Vanessa. It's like, hey, do you still talk to Colt? And Vanessa responds back and says, oh, yeah, we talk every day. And then Jess just fucking loses it, runs back into the hotel, nails him in the head with her high heels. It's awesome.
So Colt is such an asshole. He's like trying to get the second Brazilian wife number two. He's like, and she's so similar. Jess is so similar to Larissa. They look like clones. This is clearly some kind of trauma cycle that Colt is reliving. And Colt is just texting randos his dick nonstop.
Oh, yeah. Nonstop. Oh, that's another thing, is he's just constantly fucking lying. And he will never acknowledge it. Like, even when confronted with evidence that he's just be like, why you X, Y, and Z? And it's so fucking frustrating to watch. But he has one of the many reasons why they end up breaking up is that Colt is sending his cock to everyone on the internet.
Yes. And it's great because Jess confronts him on it, and Jess is just like, every day you wake up and you send picture of my dick. Wait, what does she say?
She says, you love everybody. You send your dick to everybody. Say hello, good morning, my dick. I love you. Happy Halloween, my dick.
Merry Christmas, my dick.
Happy Arbor Day, my dick.
And Jess is right. Like, normally you're not supposed to be on the side of someone assaulting another human being with a high heel shoe. But it's like, yeah, Jess, go. Hit him in the temple with the shoe.
Yeah, no, that's like the one, I think the one time where I was like, instead of being like, oh, you shouldn't do that. Like, yeah, no, physical violence is sometimes justified.
and so Colt is like an asshole. He lies to everybody. Now he's like on television relationship number three with the girl that he was cheating on television relationship number two with.
Yeah, he's just like the whitest of trash and he's disgusting.
Yeah, and he lives with his mom. And speaking of people who live with their mom, tell us a little bit about Big Ed and why Big Ed sucks.
Okay, so Big Ed is apparently like the normie favorite of like,
oh, yeah.
Normies like Big Ed. I had no idea because on all of the subreddits that I sit on all day, they call him Big Pred. And the reason why they call him Big Pred is because Ed's mission in life is to get pussy from a 20-year-old.
Yes.
He's 54
you're right.
years old. He
you're
does not
right.
have a neck. And his first relationship was with Rose, and Rose was Filipino. And he lied to Rose. Well, not like lied, but he was just like a huge douche over in the Philippines. Like he goes to the Philippines. He's like, what the fuck? This isn't America. And he's like, I want you to take an STD test. And she's like, okay, yeah, I'll take an STD test if you take an STD test. And he's like, I don't really feel comfortable at a Filipino hospital getting an STD test.
Yeah, but you'll send your fiance into a Filipino hospital to get one.
Yeah. And then he lies to her bio. This whole relationship, she's been like, I want to have more kids. My dream is to have more kids. And then he waits until he gets to the Philippines to be like, surprise, I had a vasectomy. And she's like, why didn't you tell me that? And he's like, you don't understand. I'm 54, and it's expensive to raise kids in America, blah, blah, blah. Like, this, that, and the, like, he won't just answer the question.
Yeah, he's also lied to this woman about his appearance, right?
Yeah, he lied about his height. I think he's of canon height is 4'11 or something. He said he was 5'2.
He's under 5 foot?
Yeah, he is.
If you're going to lie about your height, at least say you're 5'10 or something. Like, going up to 5'10. Oh, God, Big Ed, no.
And the reason why people, I think, hate Big Ed a lot is not exactly, like, Colt is frustrating because he's constantly just, like, arrogant. But Ed is just, like, he tries so hard to make you feel bad for him.
Yes.
Like, Rose breaks up with him at the, she's like, I don't, you lied to me. And I don't want, he's like, oh, so what, I'm a bad person? Rose is like, yeah. And then leaves, and then he's sitting there crying at the camera like, I don't believe in love anymore, blah, blah, blah. But Ed is also a fucking douchebag. The reason why his marriage ended is because he cheated on his ex-wife, which I don't know who the fuck wants to be the side chick to big fucking Ed. But Ed's attack dog is his daughter, Tiffany, who is a massive cunt. Like, there's no other way to describe her except she's a huge cunt. On 90 Day, The Single Life, Ed starts dating a new 26-year-old named Liz, and his daughter is just, like, the cuntiest of cunts. He's so insecure. He's constantly just making the exact same mistakes over and over again. He's like, I need to know that you're not talking to any other guys, and I saw you talking to a male coworker at work, blah, blah, blah. And then he ends up flying her out to Vegas. His daughter is just unlocks her super cunt mode. And Liz, and then, so they're at the hotel, and Liz overhears Ed's daughter being a cunt and, like, making fun of her. So she's, like, all pissed off, and she's like, I don't want to talk about this in front of the camera because I don't want to embarrass her or you. And Ed just won't fucking drop it. He's like, tell me what's going on. Tell me what's going on now. And so she just freaks out at him. She's like, okay, I'll tell you, blah, blah, blah. And Ed is like, why are you yelling at me? So Ed goes there and is like, putting on this show of, like, being on the phone with the airline, pretending that he's going to change his ticket. And he admitted to all this on the tell-all. So she changes her ticket.
Because she thinks Ed is changing his ticket.
Yeah. And then he's like, she abandoned me in Las Vegas.
And it's like, no, no, no. You abandoned her at the Arizona airport, wherever the fuck Ed lives. Like, Liz goes home, Ed spends the rest of his time in Vegas, like, hitting on strippers, and what he calls them sugar babies.
Yeah, and then he's like, well, oh, fuck you, I'm gonna hit on the sugar babies. And then within, like, a two-week period of them dating, 2 weeks, he's like, I love you, I want you to move in. She's like, we're going too fast. He's like, am I not your priority? He's just, like, such a douche.
He's, like, super controlling, and yeah, it's exactly like Sriracha said, like, he is the quintessential Reddit nice guy, like, he'll cry for the cameras. He'll always be like, poor me, poor me. Like, whereas Colt is just like a capital A asshole. He's a liar, and he doesn't seem to have that many problems telling lies.
Oh, yeah, no, he'll lie, and then he'll just be like, yeah, I lie to women all the time. What about it?
Yeah, it's great. And so these two, Colt and Ed, the biggest villains in series history, had a monster mash on the set of 90 Day The Single Life Tells All. It was the King Kong versus Godzilla. It was the Freddy versus Jason. These two were just going at it, hammer and tongs, on this special. And I'm going to play a couple of clips for you right now so you can hear the Big Pred versus Colty.
Fuck yeah.
Ed, the difference between you and I know I'm a piece of shit. I'll lie to women, I'll sleep with them, and still expect to have a girlfriend waiting for me. You can't do that.
Yeah, but...
I don't care. Okay, you always have a but. You'd rather be Big Ed.
Am I a self-absorbed asshole? Perhaps I am.
What is your fault? What is your problem? Why
okay,
can't
so
you be married?
Here's
Why
my,
can't you be
here
with
is
somebody?
My problem. I've always wanted attention. I was dancing on pool tables 12 years ago in a Nacho Libre costume. I was the...
What about now?
I don't know. I'm just working through it.
This is what I like. Instead of being called out on his problems, Colt is using all of his television time to mercilessly attack Big Ed. Because he knows that when his mouth is attacking Big Ed, no one else's mouth is attacking Colt. Now, here's the problem. Big Ed went into this episode being like, I'm going to be a damaged nice guy. Like, I'm crying. Oh, I'm a nice guy. I'm going to cry on TV. Like, Colt's tactic is, I am going to be a merciless asshole. And Big Ed doesn't adjust to this tactic. Big Ed doesn't start firing back at Colt and like calling him a douchebag or anything. Big Ed is stuck in nice guy mode. And so all he can do is just cry and cry and cry more. And it's like, no one is sympathizing with you, Big Ed. You're Big Pred. We call you Big Pred.
Ed is the reason that you two are no longer a couple because you were taking the relationship too fast?
Sorry.
Oh, he's crying again, Asterios.
We moved way too fast. Like she didn't have a chance. Our relationship didn't have a chance.
Because the moose and ex-booger got her to move in after 2 weeks.
So everything she said is true.
Right, so he's here crying on TV, and it's like he was the most controlling person in the world. He would get mad at her for, like, texting other guys, like, for hanging out with her friends. Like, he demanded literally all of her attention. He demanded her and her daughter move in with him right away, and he was just such an asshole to her, and then he dumped her. And now he's on TV crying about it.
Yeah, there's a part in this tell-all where he's like, every fucking time I would just tell her, get out. And then one day she actually did. Like, yeah, Ed, what did you expect was going to happen?
You screamed at her, get out. What's wrong with you?
He is very, and another big problem with Ed is that he like dates single parents and then like does not give a shit about the girl's kids, which like, I get it. Not everybody wants to raise children, but maybe you should not be dating single moms then. Like, and there's this one point he's like, well, obviously your daughter can come along with you when you move in my house. It's like, yeah, fucker, the daughter's 3. Where's she gonna go?
I know, he's like, I'm doing you such a big favor by letting your 3-year-old move in. And like, oh, when he asked her to move in, he asked her to move in on national television, on a beach, with cameras and producers there. He gives her, like, no chance to say no.
Oh, yeah, and how he originally asks her out is he's asked her out while she's working at her restaurant. It's just everything about this guy is sticky and gross.
Oh, my God. All right, so this next part is Big Ed and his now ex-girlfriend, Liz, who he treated horribly, arguing about why they broke up.
Liz, you knocked me off my world, man.
Well, you shut me out.
I don't want to get hurt.
I got hurt. You hurt me. You just completely left me, and you promised me you wouldn't leave me. You blocked me and went to Vegas and ranted about your sugar babies.
Yeah, and then they cut to a photo of Big Ed in a, it's like, VIP room with two strippers. And this is a photo he's texted to his ex to be like, ah, look at me. I'm with sugar babies. Look at me. I can hire prostitutes in Las Vegas. No one with money can do that.
Yeah, like, why the fuck? This is such a limp dick brag to, like, not even, oh, I have 20 girlfriends. You just don't know them because they go to different schools. It's like, nah, look at this hot girl I paid to hang out with me. Like, oh, wow. I bet she's very upset. Also, like, homegirl, you need to get it together. You're on TV crying over not getting Big Ed's dick anymore. You need to have a little bit more. Like, I get that the clout is noteworthy, but you, come on, you're not even on the real TLC. You're on Discovery Plus.
Oh my God. Well, look, and to give her credit, Big Ed started crying way before her. We're like 20 minutes into this special and she has just started crying.
I know, but Big Ed cries over fucking everything.
That's true.
What is a relationship to you, Ed? Is it just someone you confess you love to and then after 2 days go hang out with a bunch of other girls? Is that love to you?
I'm trying to fill my emptiness. Liz, look at me. Okay, look at me.
I'm looking at an asshole right now.
Riz, Liz, please. I've never
been in therapy. I know that there is a lot I need to work on for me. I'm going to be honest. I'm an asshole. When we fight, I'm an asshole. I am. And I'm sorry. I'm a dick.
So Ed plays a couple of classic jerk-off cards. Number one, I'm in therapy. Okay, first off, like, everyone's in therapy. Mental health is very easy to get a hold of these days. Like, most people should be talking to someone about their problems once a week. So it's like, bravo for you. You're 55 years old and, like, you've got TV money and you're finally in therapy.
I'm proud to announce that I am dating my BetterHelp counselor.
My 20-year-old BetterHelp counselor from Portugal.
She's just so beautiful. Her profile picture.
And the second thing is he goes like, I'm an asshole. I'm a dick. And like, that's another thing awful people do. They're just like, I admit it. I'm an asshole. I'm a dick. And it's like, just because you're saying it and you're self-aware of it doesn't mean you didn't do something horrible to hurt somebody.
I think Colt at some point during this literally says the exact same line. Like, yeah, I'm an asshole, Ed, but at least I know I'm an asshole. I'm like, yeah, Colt.
Maybe you shouldn't be super proud of this.
Yeah, perhaps.
I don't know what's going on. I feel like you're just saying one thing and doing something else.
Do you want to respond?
No, I mean, with all due respect, I think he's just showboating a little bit, but that's fine. But
me or him?
You.
I'm clearly
listening. Hey, I'm not showboating. I'm being honest. Every day, every action you take, you can decide, hey, do I want to be an asshole and selfish, or do I want to be a better person?
Yeah. Guess what's one Colt picks?
You pick the asshole every chance you get.
They both pick the asshole.
Until you decide not to, I'm sorry, dude. You're going to be unhappy, and you're going to drag everyone down with you.
I love you, Dad, but you got to figure out what you want.
This is his dumb cunt daughter. Yeah.
Even his daughter's attacking him on television. So, like Sriracha said before, both Colt and Big Ed have attack dogs. Colt's attack dog is his mother, who he lives with. On marriage number two, he's living with his mom. So Big Ed is like, well, I'm going to attack Colt's elderly mother on national television to try to regain some control of this fight. And here's what happens.
I'm going to be honest. I think it's time for Colt to get off the nipple. And you need to stop fighting.
Oh, fuck you. Oh.
Fuck you. They love cursing on Discovery Plus.
Fuck you.
Your own age instead of this precious little girl here you're trying to. Why don't you find somebody that you're in love with instead of going after these poor little girls that think you're something? I don't know what. You have no right to talk about dating.
Hey, listen.
You're a jerk.
Hey, I don't think. Demi, it's not your job to fight his battles.
Oh, I want a 20-year-old. So people say, oh, this guy can get a 20-year-old. You don't care about how you feel about somebody. Why don't you find love instead of somebody that's a kid?
Listen.
This mentally ill woman is making sense. So Ed, after playing the crying nice guy card, decides that he's going to pivot to attacking someone's mom on TV and screaming, get off the nipple at an old lady. And it's like, Ed, what are you doing? Ed, you got to figure out your strategy here. You're getting killed by everybody.
And to be fair, Debbie's a fucking bitch. I don't care what he says to fucking Debbie. Debbie is a bitch. In the series, Debbie literally talks about how she makes Colt's laundry and does his bed and stuff like that.
Yeah. No, it's great that, like, Debbie is another, like, classic series villain. She intentionally broke up her son and her son's fiance's relationship by, like, sending texts, right? What was it?
Yeah, no, she intentionally, so she knew that Jess hated Vanessa. So, and she also knew that her huge douche of a son was lying about his relationship with Vanessa. So she invited Vanessa to come live at their house.
Oh, Debbie did that.
Yeah, and take care of their cats while they were in Brazil.
Oh my good. Yeah. All right. So this old lady literally sabotages her son's happiness. And, like, he doesn't deserve happiness. He's an asshole. But still, like, that's a real dick move. So now there's three monsters fighting, and two of them are focusing on Edit, and it's getting roasted. Now we're in part two of the tell-all. The producers have realized that we've spent all of part one attacking Ed. So now the producer's like, well, we got to start attacking Colt, too.
Finally.
Yeah, so, like, the host starts attacking Colt, and, like, everyone's, like, trying to focus on Colt. Here's how Colt reacts to being attacked by nine other cast members.
Colt, you say that you have a habit of lying to people.
I'm a liar, dude. That's it. I'm a liar. I've lied in the past. That's it. I've lied a lot throughout my life. Uh-huh. For whatever reasons, I was scared. I didn't want people to hate me. I couldn't handle it. I don't know. It was all bad.
That's the perfect answer. You're accused of being a liar. You go, yeah, I'm a liar.
Yeah, I'm a liar, dude.
It's great. He seems like he's not at all bothered by his lies. Whereas Ed's like, I've lied. I've cheated. I've hurt people. Feel sad for me.
I'm in there.
Cole's just like, yes, I am a liar.
And I'll do it again, bitch.
All right, so in this last clip, Colt is being attacked by a bunch of people, and he's holding up pretty well. Like, he's being attacked by his ex-fiance's new husband, the host. Ed is getting some shots in there, and then Colt plays his trump card.
All of yous, be quiet for like 30 seconds. I don't care about my ex or her new husband. Love my mother. But you do kind of butt in a little bit. I love Vanessa. I don't care what you say about her, whatever little things you might remember half-heartedly.
That's the lie you take from me, so I believe
in
you.
Don't care. I said I'm sorry. Goodbye. Move on. Get off the couch.
Yeah.
Say goodbye.
But that's an open
I'm with
eyes.
Vanessa now. In fact, I love Vanessa so much, I married Vanessa and didn't tell anybody in this fucking room.
You are married now.
Meet wifey number two.
Congratulations.
And the last one.
This is such a bizarre transition now. Why do they all pretend to be happy for him?
That's why this is so brilliant. Because when you announce that you're married, even if you're marrying like a monster, the natural reaction is congratulations. Like, you hear someone has a baby, even if they're like a teenager who shouldn't be having a baby, you go, oh, congratulations. Like, we're just programmed to like these events. So Colt plays his trump card. I married Vanessa. How are you going to attack a newly married man with his newlywed wife on TV? You can't. He's immediately the good guy.
He just spent 2 fucking hours being a total asshole to everyone. And then suddenly he's like, guess what? I got secret married. And everybody's like, whoa, Colt.
Yeah. Should they be doing that? No. Is it illogical for them to be doing that? Yes. Is it effective and does it work? Yes.
Yeah, oh man, he had that sitting in the holster. You could tell. You could totally tell he was waiting for the moment to pull that out.
Yeah, exactly. He plays his trump card, and then later he's like, I didn't tell anybody because I wanted there to be something just for me and Vanessa. I wanted something that wasn't there for the TV cameras. Another great answer.
Yeah.
Now he seems like an even better guy. A guy who we have seen lie to and cheat on multiple fiancés on national television. A guy who, when he got beaten with a shoe, we were like, yeah, beat that guy with that shoe.
Now it's like, oh, he's married, but still beat him with the shoe.
Yeah, exactly. This guy's playing it perfectly.
You could say you're wearing the big end mask all day today, but I don't think so. I think you want to have sex with her roommate. And okay. That's fine. Go ahead, have fun. But don't ask Liz to stay and like wait for you or something.
Okay, dude. Who here wants to do an over and under that you guys won't last 6 months?
Oh, nice.
Well, I'll put $100.
Why would you put because, it on them?
Oh, shut up.
Well, they've all just clapped.
He's been such a rude.
You don't know anything.
He's been such a rude, belligerent person to me all day, and wow. It's
who insulted me? Who body shamed me? Who
body shamed? Oh, shut the fuck up, Colt.
Yes, I will say Ed is a gaslighter. I can tell it. I can smell it on you. It smells like gasoline.
You're crazy.
So Colt, I could tell, learned the word gaslight watching, because people on the subreddit constantly say that about him. So he's like, oh, well, this must mean is a douchebag. So now he's just throwing it around like candy on Halloween.
We've literally seen Colt gaslighting women on camera. There is footage of Colt being like, I do not love Vanessa. I am not texting any other women. I am not cheating on you. We know you're like, we've seen you cheating on this girl. Like, you are literally like holding your fiance's nose over a gas burner and like shoving. You might as well like go to the gas station and put a pump up your fiance's nose. That's how much you're gaslighting your fiance. But Colt knows that when you're attacked with something, the best thing to do is to throw that attack at someone else.
Yeah, you just gotta say it first.
Yes,
you gotta be the first person to call somebody else a gaslighter.
You think I'm crazy?
Yeah. Listen,
you have your mother and
look
your
at you, man.
Own daughter
come on.
Telling you that you have issues to work on.
Who
don't
has
project
the
on him.
Stickers everywhere.
Oh, please.
Yeah. Yes,
you're
projecting
so hard, dude. I'm tired of your crap.
Projecting. He learned on Reddit.
The first time in my life, Fernanda, that I've ever been in therapy.
And he brings up the therapy again!
Yeah.
And everyone's laughing at him!
I mean anything.
Oh, I have a long way to go.
You have a long way to go, yes.
6 months.
But then from there,
Six months minimum.
You try to work things out, but don't waste her time or
I'm
any
not wasting
other
her
lady's
time.
Time.
I still love her. And we discussed three things today. One, and this is why I have hope that this is gonna work. One, we both know we drink too much, so no more alcohol. Two, she's going to church. I want to go to church. I need spirituality.
What?
I know we won't be able to do this on our own. Okay? I know that. And I forgot my third point. But anyways, those are the two most important.
So Ed is out of cards and he's just firing blind. He's like, I don't know God. Will God get me out of this?
I literally need Jesus. I need AA and Jesus.
Yeah. He's blaming drinking instead of himself. And then he says, we need spirituality. He can't even say spirituality right. He's pronouncing the word that he's hoping will save him wrong.
And also, I'll remember, but I had something in the quiver before I showed up today.
I had another defense too, but I totally forgot. So this is great. This episode is like the total destruction of Big Ed.
It's great. I love these tell-alls because it's like a crossover episode of all the crazy people we've been watching all season.
Yeah, it's like the Avengers of reality TV. That's exactly what it is. Like, all your favorite heroes and villains just fighting for your amusement on a tastefully decorated talk show set.
Yeah, Sean looks great. And Fernanda looks great. Everybody looks great.
Yeah, well, except Ed, who he's like, he looks like a melting candle.
He does. He's sweating like a stuck pig. And also, he still has no neck. Anybody who was curious, he does, in fact, still not have a neck.
Yeah, Jesus. With the amount of money he's making and, like, endorsements and influencer shit, he should be able to, like, buy a neck.
Did I tell you they started blurring his own merchandise? Finally, TLC.
What? Tell me about this.
He has his own line of, it's called Big Ed Wear. Where you could get, like, it's like a Teespring store where you could get his logo printed all over everything. And TLC has recently started blurring it out like they blur out the Coca-Cola logo.
Oh, my God, that's great.
Finally.
All right. Well, hey, any final thoughts you want to say about 90-day fiancé, colon, the single life, colon, tell-all?
I think that Colt definitely won this battle here. He definitely came out on, even though I personally think Colt is a bigger douche than Ed, like by a slim margin, but I do think he's a bigger douche. I think he won this battle. Thanks largely in part to Debbie.
Colt does not spend any time rebutting. Colt just immediately launches another attack, because when you're attacking, you're not on the defense. Good job, Colt.
Good job,
you're a
Colt.
Terrible person, but a great television fighter.
That was the 300,000 download special of the 245,369. This is the 69,420th download. Oh, can we do that one next? Can we do 42669?
It's going to take us a while to get there. So, unless, of course, you go on iTunes to give us a 5-star rating and tell all your friends about us. The sooner you spam our show to all your contacts, the sooner we're at the 420,690 download spectacular.
Yeah, I'll do the 42069 show high because they just legalized weed up here, so it should be recreationally legal by the time we hit that milestone. So download it 1,000 times. Just do it. And if you want to leave a voicemail, we'll be back with voicemails next week. Stereos, read that voicemail number.
You can call 848-863-5343, or you could just record a voice note on your phone, or you know how to record yourself, and email it to theloudestpodcast@gmail.com.
You can still get the sticker. Head on over to patreon.com/serious. We get the FNF sticker this month by Dylan. It's a really good sticker. Loving the art style, loving all of that. You got to pledge $15. You also get the video version of this podcast. You can see all my beautiful porgs, and we will see you next week.
We love you. We'll talk to you later.
Bye.